Alright guys, so if you've been jamming with us, you know that lately we've been doing music from the late 50s and the early 60s. And one thing that I absolutely love about this era of music is like just the crispness and the unfiltered quality vocals. In the vocals.
Yes,
and we said this in our previous reaction, when with this era of music, you had to have talent because there were no machines, there was no auto-tunes, there was nothing to kind of hide your vocals.
No disguising.
So, right, no disguising. So the artist we're going to be checking out today is Paul Anka, and the song is called Put Your Head on My Shoulder. Okay. Now, what's interesting about this song is that it has been recently sampled by Doja Cat. And so it's been brought back into popularity because of the... I guess one of the verses in here.
Okay.
But let's go ahead and jump into it.
And people probably think it's an original.
Oh, yeah.
And that happens all the time. And I'm going to get on my little soapbox and then I hop down. But this is why I think reactions are so important. Because some people are like, oh, why you do reactions? I don't get it. Because the younger generation is completely unfamiliar with songs from the 50s, 60s,
70s, even 70s, 80s, 80s.
And it's because there is a cultural difference as well as a generational difference.
Yeah.
And just because you grew up with the song and you heard it a million times, with the generational gap, these kids aren't hearing the song. And they're songs that people can't believe we never heard of for those very reasons. And so exploring this music is like not only a learning experience, but it's a learning experience, like a history lesson. Yeah. It's a history lesson.
Musical journey. Yeah. Musical history lesson.
And I say this all the time. I think it should be studied in school because I think... musical influences affects just so many different things. TV, entertainment, how we act.
Right,
how
but it also gives a window into what was going on
during the time. Yes, so. Exactly. So yeah. I'm off my soapbox now. Let's go ahead
and jump into it. This is Paul Anka with Put Your Head on My Shoulder. Let's go.
Your head on my shoulder.
Here's vocals.
Hold me in your arms, baby.
Oh.
Squeeze me oh so tight. Show me that you love me too. Put your lips next to mine.
Ooh. I know this part. But it's great. It's really good.
Words I want to hear. Tell me that you love me too. Put your head on my shoulder. Whisper in my ear. Shoulder.
just felt like I was at a dance.
Yeah.
Or the drive-thru.
Yeah, homecoming.
This was beautiful.
Yes.
And see, this is so romantic, so dreamy, that it will make you want to fall in love.
Yeah.
You know, this is just a feel-good song, as opposed to, you know, songs now that don't give you that feeling.
So I absolutely agree with you. I thought this was a great song, very dreamy, gives you the feeling of love and romance. And, you know, during the time when they were making songs like this, they knew what they were doing. Because when they would have a crush or feel butterflies or something like that, you would hear this. It would make you think about that special person.
Right.
Or if there was like homecoming or prom or something like that.
Yeah.
This is like a slow jam kind of song.
I feel like I need like a poodle skirt and some tulle underneath.
So yeah, this is great. And the other thing is, you know, just the clarity and the quality in his voice when he's singing. Now, you know, he's not the greatest singer, but the one thing that you can really appreciate about his voice is that it sounds authentic. Mm-hmm. It sounds like this is a guy that is singing and he's putting his heart and soul into this song. And he's telling the girl, hey, look, put your head on my shoulder and don't worry. Let me be your man. Let me take you away. Now, you asked me if I had heard this song before, and I told you that I haven't heard it before, but I have heard the intro, because it was used in another popular artist. She just released a song last year, and she used the intro to that song, which goes like this. All right, here we go. And this song became mega popular. It was a hit by Doja Cat.
Mm-hmm.
And all of a sudden, people were they made a challenge and people were sampling this part right here.
Oh.
And they had no idea where it came from, including myself.
Wow.
And so I just learned today when we found the song that it came from Paul Anka.
Well.
So we definitely have to check out some more music from him. And of course, guys, you can leave your thoughts down below in the comment section. Let me know what you thought about this song. Anything else you want to add, baby?
No, I just thought it was very beautiful. And I think you should subscribe to the channel so more people can know where their original music came from.
There you have it. So, guys, once again, thank you all so very much for hanging out with us on our journey with 50s and 60s music. Like this video, subscribe to the channel, and we'll see y'all.
And find us on Patreon.
Yes, absolutely. Because
a lot of these songs might not make it on YouTube.
Ooh, yikes.
So
we hope they do.
Links in the description.
Absolutely.